We've watched the Justice League come together, but that's only the beginning of Warner Brothers' plans for the DCEU. What do fans have to look forward to over the next half a decade or so? Let's take a look at the upcoming DC movies that are going to blow everyone away. The upcoming solo vehicle, The Flash, has undergone a lot of changes on the road to the screen, with only one constant. Ezra Miller, who originated the role of the big-screen Scarlet Speedster in Batman vs. Superman Dawn of Justice and Justice League.
I've never done battle. I've just pushed some people and run away.
The movie, thought to be based on the Flashpoint storyline, was announced way back in 2013. Since then, a laundry list of filmmakers have come and gone from the project. In 2019, Miller even attempted to head off the potential expiration of his contract by taking a crack at the screenplay. Then, after a revolving door of creators spent years with it, production appeared to finally get on track with the hiring of IT director Andy Muschietti. The flick is currently slated for release on June 3rd, 2022, although the recent scandal in which Miller was videotaped choking a female fan in Iceland may lead to further delays or restructuring. Having gained plenty of superheroing experience during the events of his 2019 solo vehicle, young Billy Batson will be ready to hopefully take on Black Adam and Shazam 2. Of course, he may have a little help. You may recall that at the conclusion of Shazam, Batson was able to defeat Dr. Sivana by sharing his powers with his foster family. The new Shazam family of heroes will presumably have a significant role to play in the sequel.
Shazam!
The movie's mid-credits stinger revealed that Sivana, while currently imprisoned, is still a threat. He also may be keen to team up with that scene's cute little talking caterpillar, Mr. Mind, a space worm from Venus who is a heck of a lot more dangerous than he might sound. Batson will need all the help he can get with Black Adam in the picture. That said, there's always the possibility that Adam, played by Dwayne Johnson, will lean toward the hero side of his typical anti-hero depiction and end up assisting Batson and the family against the forces of evil. Shazam was a heck of a lot of fun, but we all know that superhero sequels tend to go darker. It stands to reason then that whatever the nature of Adam's involvement, young Billy is going to have some growing up to do in Shazam 2. This long-developing project may have been headed off at the pass by DC Universe. The streamer premiered Titans, featuring Dick Grayson, aka Robin, in a lead role in 2018. Of course, the comics incarnation of Grayson eventually goes on to take up the mantle of Nightwing, giving him an identity independent of Batman. It's this version of the character which has long been rumored to be getting the feature film treatment. The project was first announced in early 2017, with the Lego Batman movie director Chris McKay slated to helm the project. Since then, there has been complete radio silence from Warner Brothers on the project. McKay offered a glimmer of hope for Nightwing in late 2018, when he was asked directly whether the feature was dead on Twitter. No, you're going to have to wait though. Keep hope alive. To paraphrase Dick Grayson, Nightwing lives, always. We'll be waiting with bated breath to see whether Dick Grayson's solo vehicle actually makes it to production. The saga of the standalone Batgirl movie may reveal the most visible shift in course of the post-Justice League DCEU. Avengers director Joss Whedon was announced to be in talks to write and direct the picture in 2017, based on the Barbara Gordon version of the character. Whedon later stepped down when he realized he, quote, didn't really have a story. The film appeared to be on the far back burner until Birds of Prey emerged, leading to speculation that one of the potential spin-off characters that film could be introducing might be the Cassandra Cain version of Batgirl. That notion gained more credence when Warner Brothers tapped Birds of Prey writer Christina Hodson to resurrect the project. In an interview with the Los Angeles Times in 2018, Hodson confirmed she's working on the film, but wouldn't reveal exactly what path the character will take or when audiences might see Batgirl take flight. Oscar nominee Ava DuVernay is set to blow everyone away with DC's The New Gods. DuVernay, best known for Selma and A Wrinkle in Time, will direct the film based on the comics from legendary creator Jack Kirby. The New Gods first arrived as part of Kirby's Fourth World Saga, which he created after leaving Marvel for DC in the early 1970s. The New Gods tells the story of a war between two alien planets, the picturesque New Genesis and the ghastly Apocalypse. The war spills over to the Earth when Darkseid, who rules Apocalypse, learns that humans are the key to solving the anti-life equation, which would allow him to control every living thing in the universe. It's unclear at this point which characters will be included in the film. That said, DuVernay has previously noted that Big Barda, who plays a key role in the comics, is her favorite superhero of all time for, quote, many reasons.
Oh, one last thing.
Director James Wan built his reputation as a master of horror cinema. He's the driving force behind the Conjuring universe, not to mention the Saw and Insidious series. But in 2018, he proved he can do superhero movies as well with Aquaman.
The mission to come aboard.
Though the movie had all the trappings of a light superhero adventure, one scene in particular showed off Juan's horror roots. Arthur and Mira's detour through the Kingdom of the Trench, where they came under attack by carnivorous beasts, felt straight out of one of the director's blood-soaked fright flicks. Interestingly, the terrifying world depicted in this scene will be expanded to feature length in The Trench, a spin-off being scripted by freshman screenwriters Noah Gardner and Aidan Fitzgerald. Juan will executive produce the film with Peter Safran, who revealed to The Hollywood Reporter that he was hoping for a Trench movie even before Aquaman proved to be a huge hit. If and when it finally gets released, The Trench could prove to be a welcome departure from other superhero blockbuster fare. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Looper videos about your favorite superheroes are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.